my channel. It's your girl Kanaya coming back to today with another video. If you are new, welcome. If you are not, welcome back. So before we get into today's video, I just want to give y'all a rundown on how Vlogmas is gonna go for me. Today is currently December 2nd, so my Vlogmas is not going to be like day to day because I don't really do a lot. So I'm gonna just vlog and like give y'all video like content whenever I do something that I feel like is worthy of recording for like a Vlogmas day. I know some people is doing Vlogmas like day to day, some people is doing Vlogmas like weekly. My Vlogmas is gonna be like today's day 2. I might pop back day 5. Like it all depends on like what I got planned or like what I'm gonna do with my family and friends. Hold on, let me fix this hair. I don't have a flat iron, so I'm trying to get it as straight as I can. Okay, so today's video is going to be like a Q&A about my pregnancy thus far, because from like since I've been pregnant, I just been doing like when I found out what I was having, the story time. And I never really gave y'all like a sit down video about like how it's actually going. I think I have. Y'all don't know. I've been putting out so many videos that I don't even know what I recently did or what I did in the past. So that's just what today's video is going to be about. It may seem boring to y'all, but I feel like this is going to be good because everybody's having a baby in 2023. So I don't know about y'all, but I like pregnancy content. Way before I even got pregnant, I was just watching pregnant people because it's just like exciting to see somebody's journey on bringing their life into this world. So yeah, so I have a screenshot, some questions, and then if the video is not at the length I want it to be, I'm gonna look up some more and then we're gonna get it cracking like that. So without further ado, let's jump right into these questions. So the first question is, how many months pregnant are you? I am currently 6 months pregnant. This pregnancy has like went so fast in a blink of an eye, but it feel like I just found out what I was having the other day, and I found out what I was having at I think 12 weeks. So it's been going by fast for me. So that's question number one. I am 6 months pregnant. Almost done. Number two is, how did your family react to the news? If you haven't watched my pregnancy story time, how I found out, go watch that video because I answered this question in that video. But if you just want to watch this one, I'm gonna just go ahead and give you the tea. My family was beyond ecstatic. Like, I thought everybody was gonna be upset, everybody was gonna be like, girl, what's going on, what were you doing, blah blah blah. But everybody is so happy. They was happy, they happy now. They just so excited to meet him. That ties into question number three. I also did a video on this as well. So go back and watch my like recent pregnancy videos that I've been doing because yeah. The sex of my baby, he's a boy. A cute chocolate boy. I hope he come out chocolate. Like, cause I'm chocolate, his father is chocolate. Just come out chocolate, baby. So yeah, question number four is, do I want any more children? For me right now, a lot of people is saying I'm gonna change my mind in the future, but right now my mindset is I'm one and done. Pregnancy is, like my mom told me the other day, pregnancy is not for everybody. Everybody probably want multiple kids, but until you actually sit and become pregnant and have to deal with all the symptoms, can't do things that you would normally do, pee constantly, food appetite changes, it's just like a lot that comes with the pregnancy. And people just think it's all sunshines and rainbows and you just pop out with a baby, and that's not what it is. Cause that's what I thought it was. Even though I've seen my sisters pregnant and seeing how they was going through like bodily changes and like changing mentally and physically, it's different when you actually go through it yourself. So right now, I'm one and done. That's the answer to that question. Question number five is, what has been your biggest craving? My absolute most biggest craving, I'm gonna say two because they neck and neck. Captain Crunch cereal, the yellow box. gotta stay with me, a yellow box. And strawberries with sugar, to be exact. He don't really like sweet things. Like, I be eating like Pop Tarts and Gushers and fruit snacks. He don't really get down with that type of stuff. But he love him some Cap'n Crunch. Well, we love us some Cap'n Crunch. And strawberries, especially like midnight, not even midnight, like between the hours of 3 a.m. and 5 a.m. He's loving some strawberries. I don't care what nobody got to say. Buy me like a little 2, 3, 4, what, how many ever cartons of strawberries, and they all gonna be gone. He loves strawberries, y'all. What has been the best part of being pregnant? The best part is now, well, my sister gonna see this and be like, girl, you lying. But I'm so serious, y'all. I love feeling my baby kick and move. Like, it's just, it just like bring me to like tears sometimes. I be just smiling ear to ear. I love feeling him move, because it's just like, it's really a human in my stomach that's like moving around, that can hear me, that's feeding off my energy, my emotions, what I'm eating. Like, he hear my heartbeat on the inside. So just, I feel like my whole like best part of being pregnant is just knowing that there's somebody connected to me. Like, you know how you can have friends and family that's like, oh yeah, we get along so good, like this is my bestie. But having somebody that actually like knows you from the inside, it's just, I feel like it's a different feeling for me. So that's my favorite thing about being pregnant. Number 7 is, what's the worst part about being pregnant? Baby. The worst part about being pregnant is I cannot do the things that I usually do. Like, if you watch my videos from like over the summer, you know I like to smoke. I like to smoke a lot, a lot. I used to smoke so much, but now that I can't do that because I'm pregnant. And I know some people was like still smoking and like was smoking when they was pregnant. I just don't feel comfortable with smoking while pregnant, knowing that my baby is getting high with me, or it can affect him negatively. I just don't like to feel like to think of the thought of that. So that'll probably be the worst part. And peeing a lot. Like, I can go, not saying I do, but I can go like some time without drinking fluids and still have to pee. Like, where is from where I have to pee if I didn't drink any fluid that's going to make me pee? I don't know. But those are the worst things to me. Question number 8 is, do you have any names picked out? His name is set in stone. There is one person in my family, I ain't gonna call nobody out, but there's one person in my family that, he just like hating on my baby name. And I don't like that, because as long as me and his father is okay with his name, I don't care what nobody else gotta say. And I told him that, I told everybody in my family that, because his name is set in stone. I love his name. I would not be telling you guys his name until maybe his baby shower video, or when I introduce him to y'all. But yeah, his name is picked out. For like, my family knows his name and my friends, just nobody else. For now, we call him Baby D, because he's going to take my last name. My last name is Dobbins. So Baby Dobbins is his name for right now, until I want to tell y'all. Excuse me. Until I want to tell y'all his name. Question 9 is, who will be there with you during labor? There's only going to be one person there with me. The person that I feel like I'm going to need and I depend on the most, my mother. It was going to be my mother and my grandma, the one I stay with. But my grandma is just, I don't know how older people is in y'all family, but she's a lot. And I just don't want to have to deal with any negativity on like a day that's going to be the most special to me. Like, so that's all I'm going to say about that. So it's just going to be my mother. I know a lot of y'all is probably going to be like, why his father isn't going to be there and blah, 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 blah. I'm probably going to do a story time on that, like, after he's born, because I don't want to put any, like, negative words in the air and, like, really put y'all in my business until I'm ready to put y'all in my business. So, answer that is going to be my mother. Question is, do you have a birth plan? I currently don't have a birth plan, but on TikTok I seen like a lot of people, like, I don't know if because I post a lot of pregnancy like things on my TikTok and like it, but that's all I see is people that's already done had their baby or people that's pregnant. And I've seen a lot of birth plans. I saved a few because I like what they were saying. I'm probably going to make my birth plan in my third trimester. This is my last month in my second trimester, so I'm going to be getting a birth plan soon. Well, making a birth plan soon. I'm out of breath, y'all. Number 11, will you record your labor? I will. I want to. But a lot of people saying how my mom is not really like, not saying she old because my mom is young, hunty, but she don't know how to work a lot of things, and I want her to be there more so for me than learning how to figure out how to work the camera, because the type of camera I have a Canon G7X Mark III. The camera I have is, after I think it's 13 or 16 minutes, it cut off and you'll have to like start it over. And I would rather much her like be there guiding me, helping me, than just keep running back to the camera to record and record and record. I'm not saying that I'm not going to record. I am going to record like probably on the way to the hospital, like me having contractions and stuff like that, because I know that there's some footage probably when I'm not feeling like probably gonna pick up the camera like to update y'all. Definitely gonna update y'all when he's there. Y'all probably won't see his face in that video, but I'm going to be recording my labor. It's probably just not gonna be the whole thing that y'all would like to see and that other people record at their labor. That's the question to that. That's the answer to that question. Natural or medicated labor? I'm going in with a strong mind that I can do this with no epidural, but I know everything don't go as planned. And I don't have a high pain tolerance, but my only concern is that with the epidural, they say you have to sit really still. And this year, I've become like okay with shots. Usually I cry with shots, I move with shots, and I know epidural you have to be absolutely still because it's going in your like spine or whatever. So that's something that I'm like, it, not even the labor part, I'm just terrified for the epidural. So I'm going in with the mindset that I can do this naturally and I don't have to have an epidural. But if I can't take the pain and epidural is what I need, epidural is what I'm gonna get. So for the answer for that is, I'm gonna just say both, but really natural. Are you scared about labor? I just really answered this, but I'm kind of scared, but then I'm kind of not. I'm just scared about the contractions because a lot of people say they feel like cramps, really. And I don't really have bad cramps like everybody, like most people do. So I can really sit through my cramps. A lot of people I know can't, and it just like hurt them to like their core. So I'm just scared to see how the contraction is going to feel, how I'm going to react. And then they said pushing out doesn't hurt. But I just think I'm going to have my own completely, totally different experience than everybody else that I've been seeing. The stories my mom tell me, the stories my sister tell me. So I just feel like other than the contractions, the epidural is probably the scariest thing for me. I'm not really scared about like pushing him out, but the things that lead up to me pushing him out is what I'm scared of. Most look forward to after pregnancy? Just becoming a whole totally different person. Like, I wouldn't say that I'm not mature, but I'm not the maturest, as you could say. I don't even know if that's a word, but I'm not the maturest that I know I could be. So I'm just ready to see like a new version of me. Having my own little baby, like, I'm just so excited. I think other than me seeing how I change as a person, having someone to look after, someone that's I have to raise into a man, like, I'm a woman, so I don't really know too much about like raising a man. And yeah, I think that's really it. I'm most forward to seeing myself change and having a little baby. Question 15, will you breastfeed? I am going to breastfeed, but I know that doesn't always go as planned. Like, I don't want to put too much stress on myself that, like, because some I've heard stories that breastfeeding hurts, and I don't want to be in so much pain that. So I'm just keeping a open mind about breastfeeding, but I'm going in breastfeeding because this may be a little TMI, y'all. But my milk has started to come in, so I know that I will have milk for him. I just need to see how it's going to feel and how it's going to impact me mentally to really have my final say. Do you plan to work or be a stay-at-home mom? I plan on being a stay-at-home mom. Probably up until he's like a month. I really don't really trust the whole what is it called, daycare thing. I just seen too many stories about like the people at the daycare and mistreating kids. Like, anything can happen. Just if I was like when I'm breastfeeding, I don't want them to, like, if you don't have any milk to give him, any like powder milk, I'd rather just trust myself or like my family to watch him versus like put him in a daycare. So I'm going to see how it is, like if I can find someone to watch him. The only person I really will have to watch him is my grandmother, but she's getting older, so I know she's not going to be able to move around a lot. She forget things already, so it's just a lot. That's why I plan on working now up until I'm probably about to like give birth, so I can have money saved so that I can be out of work for the time that I need to be out of work. Number 18, will you make your own baby food? Yes, I've been seeing videos on TikTok, and a lot of people get like the baby bullets, like a little baby blender. And I just feel like it'd just be an exciting thing to do, to say, like, I made my baby food. I didn't go out and buy this. I actually made this at home. To be eating fresh food instead of food that's, like, processed and made in the store and the factories and then got shipped out and stuff. But to answer that question, yes, I will be making his own food. The last and final question is, do you have any nursery ideas or theme? I think I kind of answered this in my story time or whatever. But I currently live with my grandmother, so I just have like a room to myself. It's a pretty big room, but I just have a room to myself. So he would not be having a nursery. And I really think nurseries is for, like, I don't know. And then I think since this will be my first baby, even if she had an extra room for me to make him a nursery, I probably wouldn't take it, because like in my room now, like, I can just get up and like walk to him, move around and stuff, versus like going all the way out of the room, going to another room. So I don't have a nursery for him. And I don't want him to have a nursery until he's like at least 5-6 months, to where I know the routine. He's used to me, I'm used to him. We like got everything kind of settled down, packed. He's sleeping through the night and stuff like that. I just feel like right now I'm not emotionally equipped, and he's not even here yet. I'm just not emotionally equipped to be that far from him, especially if I'm going to be breastfeeding. If we're in the same room, it'll be easier for me to get up during the night to like feed him, change him, watch him, like sleep, just stuff like that. So yeah, that's all for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, comment down some questions that I didn't answer that you want to know about me and my baby love. And I will reply to them. I reply to all my comments. I see them all. They come to my phone and my iPad. Before I close the video, I am going to give y'all a bump update. So, mind you, I am 6 months pregnant. My stomach has came in the five, kind of like at the end of my fifth month. So, yeah. So, this is my stomach. He's not the biggest, but he's not the smallest. Looks so cute. So big. So, yeah. I hope you guys like this video. And I will see you in my next Vlogmas video.